howdy folks, welcome back to the channel. I am playing catch up, as many of you know. Since the beginning of October last year in 2019, I have been lacking on content because of a ridiculously crazy schedule. And so, because of that, I am returning to a lot of old news. And why not begin with Space Marine Drake, right over here, the Kenner homage figure. Now, I did touch on this figure a couple of months ago when I did a news recap video of October 2019, and he was included in there, and I talked a little bit about him, but returning to that video, watching it again, I thought, man, I didn't give this figure enough justice. He needed his own pre-order video, and so that's why we are here. So this figure is still slated for a February 2020 release, which is not too far away now. I'm filming this on January 28th, so really not too far off. We're getting there. And for the most part, the figure does use a lot from the Dutch mold, from the Predator line. Obviously, you got the cargo pants, the arms, and the boots, all from Dutch, essentially. I'm taking a look at the shirt. I'm pretty sure that's also Dutch. Obviously, the paint is different. You have like this, almost like a very, very beigeish green t-shirt to match the camo of the cargo pants. So what I'm actually taking a look now at is at the gloves. I think those should be new because I don't remember any Dutches with the same gloves. If did Dutch, I think Dutch may have worn gloves on one of his figures, the one with the jacket on, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong. And then obviously the watch is going to be the same. But I'm okay with all this. Really, if you compare this to the original 90s Kenner Drake figure, it's fine. It's totally fine. I don't think this figure needed a brand new mold. It really would have been a waste. So that's okay. And look, it's a good mold. I never had an issue with the Dutch figures by NECA. They were all really articulated and they were fine. No issues here. The sculpt was good. Obviously, they put a lot of detail into like the muscle groups and the veins. The veins aren't just, you know, painted on. They're bulging out of the skin, which is weird to say. And the clothes, all the wrinkles that they sculpted in, really, really well done. And it works well with Drake. Now the new additions. We do get those two bandoliers. We get the ones with like sniper cartridges almost, and then ones with the grenade launchers, which looks a little bit similar to the Terminator figures. I don't know if they're the same. Correct me if I'm wrong. Probably the same. And you got the new shoulder pad, which is pretty neat looking. And the big thing is the giant turret, which again borrows mostly from the Aliens figure Vasquez. And then you do, I even have her right here, the Kenner style Ripley as well. So it borrows a lot from them, but it adds attachments. One of the attachments is this giant, like, double-bladed spear. You have a knife on one end and then a slightly smaller one on top of it, which is really, really cool. So, and much like Vasquez, it does have the arm that wraps around his waist and connects to his back. And the back is crazy looking because that actually acts as storage for those knife attachments. The figure is absolutely crazy looking. And again, a lot of hints to the original toy with those knives and stuff, so I definitely approve of that. It's really cool. The head sculpt, I think it's fine. Obviously, with a lot of these Kenner homage figures, the likenesses are really exaggerated, right? Not so much with Ripley, because they borrowed that from just the movie line, but here he looks like he's taken a big old dump. Really, he is constipated, perhaps. he's all over the place. He really is. I don't know what he's thinking about when he's making this face. I don't know what's going through his head, but he's upset. And it's a brand new sculpt, which is awesome. They didn't borrow anything. You do have the headgear that attaches to the side of his head, too. Looks pretty cool. Got the blonde hair, just like the original one. And definitely doesn't look anything like the movie. You know, those Kenner toys were pretty insane. So, overall, the figure looks really, really cool, and he actually is posed with the club-exclusive purple alien, the Kenner one, which makes it even cooler looking, and I do own that one, so they're definitely going to be sitting side-by-side with each other. And if you have the club-exclusive Vasquez, they'll definitely work well with each other, because obviously they were a team in the movie. Why wouldn't they be a team in the toy line? So I am very much looking forward to this figure. It's really not too far away, honestly. Again, February, a couple days away, right? I don't think NECA announced when they're going to start shipping this out to retailers and, you know, like the likes of Target and stuff. I heard Walmart is going to be getting some Alien Predator stuff. They hinted at it with the 40th anniversary line. I don't know if that'll apply to other Alien or Predator figures. We'll see. But yeah, definitely let me know if you're going to pick this guy up. I definitely am. He's going to come in the regular carded Kenner homage packaging, just like all the others, not an ultimate figure, and he's going to be priced at $23.99, so, you know, average price these days. NECA prices obviously used to be cheaper, but nowadays they're adapting to the market, so everything's a little bit more expensive, but I want this figure and definitely expect a review the moment it arrives at my doorstep or when I find it at Target. If I find it at Target, because at my Targets, it's kind of like gambling. I never found the Golden Angel there. I never saw the Alien 3 creature pack there, and among others. I can't name any more off the top of my head, but we'll see. Hopefully he will arrive, and if he does, he'll go on my shelf. I don't know why I pointed at me when I said my shelf, but anywho, again, I do apologize for the old news, but I did want to give this guy his proper video, and expect that from a lot of the stuff in the October 2019 Newsweek video, because again, needs more time spent on these figures. And I'm going to do the same with the Haya Toys stuff and whatever else I touched on. And yes, Alpha Predator is coming, Hunting Grounds is coming, a couple videos away. Got to catch up first, all right? Anywho, go check out Trophy Room on Facebook, a Facebook group made for Alien Predator collectors like me, and probably like you if you're watching this video. So if you collect the toys, if you're just into the movies or the comics, or, you know, just collectibles in general, go post there. There's literally no restrictions whenever you want. Just don't be a dick. We don't like dicks over there. We really don't. And as always, people, have a good morning, evening, midday, whatever, and take care.